In March 1989, a powerful geomagnetic storm caused by a CME from the sun led to a significant power outage in Quebec, Canada. The CME reached Earth on March 13th, inducing geomagnetically induced currents, GICs, that disrupted the Hydro-Quebec power grid. This is a news broadcast from 1989 on the subject. Find the full video in the description.
6 million people across Quebec woke up to darkness and disbelief. For the second time in less than a year, the entire province had been hit by a power failure. People at Hydro-Quebec are not positive, but they think the blackout was caused by the sun.
There was a sudden power surge in northern Quebec, just a fraction of a second. And then, like a big circuit breaker, the whole system shut down. They don't know, but they suspect it may have something to do with solar flares. Over the last week, scientists have recorded some of the largest flares this century. They send out a magnetic shower, which can interfere with transmission lines back on Earth, especially those at high latitudes.
We had a very large flare last Friday. That's almost certainly the cause of the geomagnetic storm, which started within a minute of the time that Quebec Hydro went out. So the coincidence is so close in time, it's almost too much to be chance alone.
On top of that, scientists say the solar flares will get a lot stronger over the next year. And that could mean even more blackouts like the one today.
Thankfully, the storms did not cause any more outages later that year, but it is important to realize the qualifications and measurements of the solar weather that allowed such a massive outage to happen. First of all, this was during solar maximum, a period in time where solar weather and solar storms become more numerous and explosive. The sun, like all things, goes through phases. Some years, it is dormant and lacking significant storms. This is what we call solar minimum. Other years, we see events like these. Another important thing to realize is that the storm that hit Earth during this blackout was a G5 geomagnetic storm, a massive and historic storm, sending auroras as far south as Texas and Florida. The Quebec storm measured at a DST index of approximately -589 NT. A G5 solar storm is the highest classification of solar storm on record. However, there are two other historic storms that you should know about that interacted with Earth. The first is the Carrington event, which occurred in 1859. It was also a G5 solar storm. However, it measured on the geomagnetic storm scale, with an estimated DST index of -850 NT to -1100 NT. It sent auroras as far south as the Caribbean and Hawaii. The storm that shut down Quebec's power, cutting off lights to the city for millions of people, was roughly half of the estimated weight of the storm that rocked the skies in 1859. Furthermore, in 2012, a similar storm to the Carrington event barely dodged Earth, missing us only by a matter of days. This was the solar storm of July 2012, classifying again as a G5, with a projected DST index between -1000 to -1200 NT. If a storm of this magnitude does strike Earth, the worldwide power grid would be severely impacted or even shut down. In our age, we feel as if things have always been this way, but it is easy to forget that iPhones are hardly 20 years old. Cable TV is not even 100 years old, and a global electric grid is not much older. These kinds of storms have been going on since the Earth and the Sun existed. For most planets, solar storms affect the environment just as much or more than weather on our planet. It is by sheer providence that no such storm has crippled the electric grid of Earth over the past couple centuries, but we know that these events have occurred in the past. It's not a matter of if they will occur again. It's a matter of when they will occur again. No one can give a perfect prediction. However, we do know that this year and during 2025, we will be in solar maximum, meaning solar storms are more common and extreme. Solar storms are spontaneous, meaning they are fast-moving, sometimes reaching Earth within days from their first eruption. Sign up to FlareAware and receive phone alerts when solar storms are detected. This way, you can be in the know without trying to make sense of the data. Sign up today at FlareAware.com.